Captain's Log, Stardate 47111.1. A Federation listening post along the Romulan neutral zone has detected an unidentified vessel headed for Federation space. The Enterprise is moving to intercept.
At its reported heading and velocity, the vessel will enter Federation space in approximately 47.3 seconds.
Go to yellow alert.
We have the vessel on sensors.
The ship is a Garidian scout ship. They are driving their engines too hard. Their warp core is critical.
The Garidians? What is the status of their relationship with the Romulan Empire?
They're on friendly terms and may share technology.
We are being hailed.
On screen.
Help us. We are fleeing political persecution. We seek asylum. We are being persecuted.
Their signal is breaking up.
What do you make of this, number one?
It could be a trick.
The Garidians have earned a reputation as honorable warriors, Captain. They do not ordinarily resort to trickery.
We are within visual range. The Garidians' warp drive is failing. They are dropping to sublight speed inside Federation space.
Slow to impulse.
Warbird decloaking directly ahead. The Warbird is also Garidian. They are hailing us.
This is an internal Garidian matter. Withdraw at once.
You are violating Federation space.
They have cut off transmission.
The Warbird has locked its tractor beam onto the scout ship.
Go to red alert.
These are the voyagers of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Captain's Log Supplemental. A Garidian warbird has violated the neutral zone in pursuit of a scout ship. The fugitives may be seeking political asylum, but as yet we have been unable to confirm their intentions. What do you think, number one?
The Garidians respect strength. If we show any sign of weakness, it might just encourage them to fight.
What do you suggest?
Maybe we can use our phasers until they listen to reason.
I don't want to provoke them, number one.
Maybe Maybe we can use our phasers now.
That may be too strong an action. Mr. Worf, lock phasers onto the Warbird, but hold your fire.
Aye, sir. They are locking their disruptors on us.
Maybe we can use our phasers now.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
The Garidian Warbird is similar to the Romulan Dideridex class. It is less maneuverable than the Enterprise, but it has slightly more firepower.
We'd both take a beating if it came down to a fight.
Our records identify the Warbird as the Asirim, commanded by Captain Pintara. Starfleet intelligence rates her as a capable but unimaginative tactician. I believe we would defeat them in battle, but we would suffer heavy casualties.
Mr. Data, do you have any suggestions?
As long as the Warbird maintains a tractor beam on the scout ship, we cannot beam its crew aboard. However, if we maneuvered the Enterprise between the ships, we could temporarily disrupt the tractor beam.
We will have to drop our shields to use the transporter.
I'm not willing to take that risk. Any insights, Counselor?
The Garidian captain is torn about something, as if she were faced with a difficult dilemma.
She has violated the neutral zone.
It's more than that. I think she has a personal stake in this matter.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Perhaps we should attempt to break the tractor beam.
I'm not willing to take that risk.
I believe we would defeat them in battle, but we would suffer heavy casualties.
Maybe we can use our phasers now.
I don't want to provoke them, Number One.
Perhaps we should attempt to break the tractor beam.
Make it so.
Scout ship has been beamed aboard.
Captain, the Warbird is hailing us.
On screen.
Federation Starship, this is an internal Gridian matter. You've been warned not to interfere.
Will leave Federation space at once or face the consequences.
Those people you have apprehended are dangerous criminals, Captain. My orders are to take them back to Garrett to stand trial for murder and sedition.
They are now guests aboard my ship. If you return to Gridian space immediately, I will overlook your violation of the neutral zone.
Very well. You have won this time, Captain. But I promise you, there will be a next time.
The Warbird is heading back toward Gridian space. They are activating their cloaking device. Captain, our new arrivals are requesting to speak with you. Their names are Lucana, Avakar, and Tabak.
What are your orders, Captain?
I should like to consider the situation a bit further. Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain. We should check our orders from Starfleet.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have any suggestions right now.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
What is the current situation, Admiral? Is there anything in particular we should be aware of?
Actually, things are relatively quiet right now. The only cause for concern is all the Romulan activity in the area.
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we review the situation, the Enterprise is to remain on patrol.
discovery of the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
What is this fifth scroll you mentioned?
Let me give you a bit of background. Caridian society is a rigid structure consisting of two distinct classes, the patricians and the plebeians.
Another scroll.
According to legend, the Lawgiver also wrote a fifth scroll defining the rights and privileges of the plebeian class, which were not explained in the other scrolls.
What makes you think Shaynok can help you?
My studies indicate that the followers ended up somewhere in what is now Federation space. But because our governments are not on friendly terms, I could never follow up on that research. But the Vulcan scholar Shaynok lives in the Federation and has made extensive studies of our history. I believe he may have vital information that will help us locate the followers.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
I am a scholar, Captain. My interest is purely academic. Lucana, on the other hand, is a social revolutionary. She hopes the scroll will inflame the underclasses to rebellion.
How would an ancient scroll do her any good?
The patrician stopped the Lawgiver before he could reveal his fifth scroll. Lawgiver and a few of his disciples, known as the Followers, left Gerid in 5 spaceships to start their own colony. No trace of them was ever found, and the story gradually took on mythic proportions.
Who is the Lawgiver?
His real name was Avatrunai, and he was the architect of Garidian society. His 4 scrolls became the cornerstone of our entire culture. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Garrett's history. Even if you don't agree with Lucana's goals, I urge you to talk to Shaynok and help us find the scroll for science's sake.
This could be an intriguing quest. If you're Excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later.
Captain Picard, my name is Lucana. On behalf of the oppressed underclasses of Garrett, I'd like to thank you for rescuing us.
Don't thank me too quickly. You have illegally entered Federation space, and this ship is not a haven for criminals.
I am not a criminal, Captain. I am only seeking justice for my people.
Very well. You may stay on board the Enterprise until we have sorted this matter out.
Do not dismiss me so quickly, Captain. The fate of all Garrett is hanging in the balance.
Why do you say that?
I am searching for the fifth scroll. It's the only way to give the plebeians the freedom they deserve.
Who are the plebeians?
They are the underclasses of Garrett, forced by law to serve the patricians, their masters, for the past 1,000 years.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
From tyranny, because the scroll gives the rights to the plebeians, Garrett's lower classes. That's why the government doesn't dare let me succeed.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to. Perhaps we can talk again later. Why is your own mother trying to kill you?
She is only doing her duty. I know she doesn't want to kill me, but she is under orders to prevent Lucana from finding the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
Because I believe in Lucana's crusade. Even though I was born a patrician, Lucana has made me aware of the plebeian suffering. The fifth scroll would give them a more honorable place in Garridian society.
I sympathize with your cause, but I must inform you that the Federation will not take sides in Garrett's domestic politics.
And we are not asking you to do so, Captain. When the time comes, we will fight that battle ourselves. Please, Captain, in the name of justice for an oppressed people, we need you to help us find the fifth scroll and bring it back to Garrett.
Receiving an emergency transmission from Simcoe 4.
Simcoe 4? Isn't there a research center there?
Yes, sir. The work at Merton's orbital station focuses on power generation. The researchers there are among the best in the Federation.
On screen. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Star. Starship Enterprise. How can we be of help?
Captain Picard, I am Deneb, Chancellor of Simcoe. We are in need of immediate assistance. Merton's orbital station has been attacked by an unknown vessel and does not answer our hails.
Attacked? But the station is a purely scientific facility.
Is the attacking vessel still present?
We do not know. Whoever or whatever they were, our sensors did not detect them.
Perhaps it was a cloaked Romulan vessel.
I doubt the Romulans would venture this far into Federation territory. The risks are too great.
Captain, you must hurry. The attack has destabilized the station's experimental power core. We don't know how long we have until a core breach, but I can tell you the resulting energy release and radiation would be catastrophic.
What about survivors? Did anyone get off the station?
We detected several escape pods, but we haven't recovered them yet. The pods we detected could hold only a few dozen. There are hundreds aboard the station, including families.
Set course for Simcoe 4. I hope it's not too late.
Thank you, Captain. I hope you arrive in time.
We'll do our best. Picard out. Dr. Crusher.
Crusher here.
Doctor, we may shortly be taking on a large number of wounded, possibly hundreds.
How much time have I got?
Not enough, I'm afraid. Picard out. Miss LaForge?
Yes, Captain.
We're en route to Merton's orbital station. They've been attacked, and they're going to need immediate assistance. See what you can find out about their experimental power core.
I'll see what I can dig up, but the Simconians do some advanced work. It may take a while to figure it all out.
Then I suggest you work quickly. Millions of lives on the planet's surface may be at stake. I expect a full analysis of the situation and our options as soon as we're within sensor range.
Yes, sir.
Engage. The Simcoe system in response to a distress call regarding Merton's orbital station. The station was apparently attacked by unknown forces, leaving it in danger of a power core breach.
We're within sensor range of the Merton's orbital station, sir.
On screen. Forge?
The Forge here.
Report, what is the condition of the station?
You're looking at what's left of the Merton's orbital station, one of the largest research centers in the Federation. The focus of their work is on power generation. 5 years ago, they built the prototype of an experimental power core, and it's been running the station ever since.
Power generation studies? That doesn't warrant an assault like this.
I've been in contact with Starfleet headquarters. Power generation is only part of what this station studies. For several years, researchers here have been working on new ways to detect cloaked vessels.
If the Romulans discovered this, they might have risked a raid. The Simconians did not detect the attacking ship. It may have been cloaked.
That's speculation, Mr. Worf. We have no proof the Romulans were involved.
Well, whoever it was, something powerful punched through the station's shields and sliced off an entire research wing.
What do you mean, sliced off?
There is insufficient debris in the area to indicate that the missing section was destroyed. It is possible the attacker simply removed it.
Geordi, could that be what destabilized the power core?
No, and that's what I can't figure out. Damage to the upper deck should only cause minor problems, but I'm reading serious power fluctuations. Maybe serious enough to breach the power core's containment field.
What will happen if the containment field fails?
I can't say for certain, but with the amount of energy that thing can put out, I wouldn't want to be around it when it goes.
Is there any way to shut down the core?
There's a fail-safe mechanism which is supposed to jettison the core automatically in an emergency.
I'd say this qualifies as an emergency. Why wasn't the core jettisoned?
The only way to prevent it is by manual override. Someone has to be there to stop it.
That means there's someone still alive in there. Data, are you picking up any life signs?
The station's shielding is interfering with our sensors. I cannot tell if any of the crew are still alive. However, life support is still functioning. But power readings indicate that it may fail at any time.
Dr. Crusher?
Crusher here.
We are nearing Merton's station. Are you prepared for casualties?
My staff is ready to do double shifts. We can handle about 330 emergency cases, but we'll have to beam the rest down to Simcoe.
Understood. What is your recommendation?
We can't do anything from here, but to get an away team aboard, we have to find a way through those shields.
I believe I have a solution. The station's upper shields are badly damaged. If we establish a lock on a transporter on the upper decks, a transporter beam could penetrate the weakened shields.
Once we're in, we should be able to jettison the power core. Then we could lower the station's shields and evacuate the wounded.
Very well, number one. Make it so.
Geordi, I want you and the rest of the away team ready to go in 20 minutes.
We'll be there in 10.
Beam down coordinates selected.
Who built this place. The entire hull is lined with a liquid tritanium-duranium alloy in a memory gel suspension. It's completely self-sealing.
You mean the station heals itself?
That's one way to put it. The attack caused major structural damage. If this were any other station in the Federation, we'd be standing in a vacuum.
With all the damage this station suffered, I'm surprised it's still holding together. It looks like she's still alive, but she's pinned under that cable. With all the damage this station suffered, I'm surprised it's still holding together.
I'm getting some life signs, but they're not good. She needs medical attention immediately. I couldn't risk firing any closer to her.
That's a high-capacity data transfer cable, probably a main communications line. Readings show damage characteristic of a phased plasma beam. This cable's built for handling information, not energy. I'm surprised it didn't just vaporize when it was hit. That's a high-capacity data transfer. No unusual readings. Show massive fluctuations in the power level. Can't imagine what could cause something like this. There's a tremendous drain, then it cuts off suddenly and even reverses slightly, almost as if something were breathing the energy. Severe power oscillations put a lot of stress on the containment field. If the field breaches, this station's had it. I've been thinking about how to free that trapped crewman. What if we use the station's transporter to remove the cable? I've already got the coordinates we need.
takes care of the worst of her injuries. She's coming around now. All life signs are strong. She should recover fully.
How do you feel?
I'll manage. You're from Starfleet, aren't you?
Yes, we're from the Enterprise. We just arrived.
Thank goodness you're here. I'm Anna Bennett, Chief Medical Officer. Listen, we've got a lot of wounded here. How many can you evacuate?
We can get everyone, but not until we lower the shield.
We can't do that until we stabilize or jettison the power core.
What happened here?
We were attacked, but I don't know who or what it was. I was headed for sickbay when something struck the hull and tore this cable loose.
Do you have any guesses who might have done this? Was there any warning?
We never knew what hit us. There was an initial attack which lasted maybe 10 minutes. Later there was a hull breach and the power systems went crazy. I don't remember anything after that. I passed out.
What did you mean when you said the power systems went crazy?
It's this insane experiment Dr. Greems and some of the other researchers put in place. A revolutionary power source. It's unstable enough to begin with. After sustaining damage like this, who knows what it'll do?
We've been reading some large power fluctuations. Is that normal?
How should I know? Those maniacs. You know what they've got down there? They plug the biggest research station in the quadrant into a singularity, a black hole.
Then why the energy fluctuations? Singularity-driven power sources are usually stable.
Greems came up with some scheme to increase the energy output. Something about gravity waves. I don't know all the details, but it involved destabilizing the containment field.
Where are the rest of the station personnel?
Most of them probably escaped when Commander Wilde gave the order to evacuate after the first attack. But I know many are trapped and can't reach the shuttle bays.
We'll be back to check on you later. Right now, we've got to stop the core breach if we can.
All right. I think I'll be fine for now.
Say we've found our intruder.
Sense. Whatever that thing may be, it's obviously not what these readings say it is.
It's sending false readings to our tricorders. It's like a chameleon. It disguises itself perfectly. If we weren't here to see it, we'd never know it was here. It could probably fool our ship sensors just as easily. This chameleon field seems to take a fraction of a second to adjust to new scanning frequencies. If I set the tricorder to randomly shift frequencies at high speed, there. I'm getting a partial reading now. Yep, it's a neutronium hull, all right, and a powerful energy source. I've never seen that much power in such a small package before.
Machine out there. It's blocking the way to primary engineering. Ideas?
We do not have sufficient weaponry to destroy the intruder.
What is it doing here?
It appeared to be drawing plasma from the third conduit cluster.
Well, that's it. It's collecting energy. Maybe if we can temporarily shut off the power, it'll leave.
Make it think the wells run dry, eh? It's worth a try.
There should be emergency shutoff controls around here somewhere.
This auxiliary panel seems to control power flow.
Unlikely.
Apparently, this object is capable of sending false readings to our sensors.
The device has some sort of chameleon field, which sends false readings to sensors and tricorders.
Interesting. The object has accelerated to warp speed.
Unfortunately, we've got too much to do here to chase after it.
Acknowledged. Picard out.
Engineering level attached to one of the conduits. Have you seen it?
I don't know what you're talking about. There shouldn't be anything down there but conduits and control panels.
I'd bet anything that's what caused the second impact and breached the hull. Sure got the weapons for it.
Your guess is as good as mine, but I can tell you for certain that it didn't belong here.
We need some help.
What is it?
We need the access code to put life support on emergency power.
But that should happen automatically.
Only if the main power has been interrupted. The core is still providing power.
So the emergency system never kicked in. But if there's main power, why shift to emergency power?
The fluctuations in main power are getting worse. A big enough surge could overload the life support system.
I warned them about using an inherently unstable power source. I never thought it would come to this. The code is 334L42.
Thank you. We'll stabilize life support. Then we'll see about that power core.
You should jettison that thing. If it breaches the containment field, life support will be the least of our problems.
We'll be back to...
All right.
Sense of timing.
I beg your pardon?
Timing, I said. You have fine timing. The one instant I cannot afford to be distracted, and in barges all of Starfleet.
I'm Geordi LaForge, chief engineer of the Enterprise. We're here to help.
Thanks for the offer, but I haven't time to instruct Starfleet in the intricacies of singularity-driven power generation, so kindly stop distracting me!
Dr. Greems, I'm chief engineer on a galaxy-class starship. It's my job to work miracles.
Have you seen a system like this before?
I'm not sure. It looks like some kind of gravity wave power source. But how can you generate gravity waves of this magnitude?
A little something I got from the Romulans. We've got an artificial singularity bottled up down there, and by varying the strength of the containment field, I was able to increase the magnitude of the gravity waves.
But now that something's got the energy flow out of phase with the containment field, we've got to get the energy flow back in phase immediately.
Not bad for a Starfleet officer. You may be of some use after all. You see, the only reason the field's held up this long is because I've been here manually compensating for the fluctuations.
Sounds like you could use an extra pair of hands. Listen, I'll handle the conduit. You maintain the containment field.
I'll keep the containment field up as long as I can. I see you already have a phase inverter and a wave reduction converter. Good. You'll need them.
A phase inverter? But that'll just make the fluctuations reverse. Unless... if we use the wave reduction converter to dampen them, the reversal will actually work in our favor.
Smarter than you look. Install the phase inverter coupling in the damaged area. Then use the wave reduction converter to bring the fluctuations down. If I can keep the containment field up, we should make it.
I'm on my way. Enterprise.
Picard here.
We've stabilized the power core. The outer shields should be lowered now.
Confirmed. We'll start evacuating the wounded immediately.
Great. That means we're done here. Beam us up.
Acknowledged.
We are being hailed, sir. It is Chancellor Daenop. On screen.
Captain Picard, you have my warmest thanks. We had really given up hope.
We are pleased to have been able to help. Have you recovered all the pods yet?
My staff tells me all the evacuees are safe and sound. And my compliments to your medical staff. Our surgeons were quite impressed with Dr. Crusher's handiwork.
I'll pass that along. The last of the injured personnel should be beamed down within the hour.
I think we can handle it from here. By the way, Dr. Greems personally extends his gratitude. He felt he owed you and your crew an apology.
Tell him we accept his apology. Picard out.
What are your orders, Captain?
Set course for the Ruinor sector and resume our patrol along the neutral zone.
Yes, sir.
Engage. Mr. Data, give me a scan of this sector.
Scanning? Sensors report no unusual activity, sir. All spatial parameters appear to be normal.
What are your orders, Captain?
I should like to consider the situation a bit further. I have decided to visit Shaynok and see whether he can help you regarding the fifth scroll.
Thank you for agreeing to visit Shaynok, Captain. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Garrett's history.
Understood. We will be underway at once. I will let you know when we arrive. Mr. Worf, inform Starfleet that we will be assisting the Garridians in their search.
Aye, sir.
Computer, what are the current whereabouts of the Vulcan archaeologist Shaynok?
According to Federation Archaeological Survey records, Shaynok is currently excavating ruins on the planet Horst 3.
Set course for Horst 3, Warp 5.
Aye, sir.
Engage.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
The Enterprise responded to a distress call from Merton Station. Good work there, Picard. Without your efforts, this could have been a real catastrophe. You saved hundreds of lives, kept the station operational, and even managed to save the experimental power core. Congratulations. Shall I go on?
Please do.
The Enterprise's presence in this region has set a lot of minds at ease, but I'm still concerned about the Romulan activity in the area. Look sharp, Captain.
Picard out. Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet, Captain.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
Standard orbit.
Greetings, Shaynock. I'm Captain Jean-Luc Picard.
Captain, how may I assist you?
What brings an archaeologist of your stature to such a remote planet?
I am excavating the ruins of a Chodak outpost. The Federation Archaeological Survey is sponsoring my work.
Who are the Chodak?
An ancient race. At their peak, the Chodak occupied most of what is now the Romulan Empire. But I thought all known Chodak ruins were on the other side of the neutral zone.
This is the first Chodak site found in Federation space. It was my good fortune to discover it.
What have you found so far?
A great deal, actually. I have uncovered evidence of an extensive administrative system, as well as examples of Chodak computer technology quite similar to our own isolinear rods.
Intriguing. Such devices would be among the oldest known examples of isolinear technology in the galaxy.
I hope to confirm that fact. I sent several rods to the Mertens orbital station for testing. They've developed a gravitic stress dating method which is extremely accurate. However, I have not yet received their results.
I'm afraid we have got some bad news for you, Shaynock. Merton's station has been attacked. It was almost completely destroyed.
Indeed. That is a great loss.
Shaynock, we have several Garidian refugees aboard who are trying to find something called the Fifth Scroll. They said you might be able to help.
Possibly. I once did extensive research on the Lawgiver and the followers. They fled into what is now Federation space 1,000 years ago, bearing the Fifth Scroll with them.
We've heard of them. So where did these followers go?
I never found the followers' colony, but your friends should not lose hope. In my search, I stumbled on one of the followers' ancient ships. The logs indicated that they had found an M-class planet suitable for colonization.
I'd be most eager to examine the site myself. I can beam down immediately.
Captain, I'm aware of your reputation as an archaeologist, but I cannot permit any visitors. The excavation is far too delicate.
Thank you for your help, Shaynock. Good luck.
And to you, Captain. Live long and prosper.
I should like to consider the situation. Chancellor, the Vulcan archaeologist Shaynock sent some artifacts to Merton Station to be tested. Can you give us any information about this?
I'm sorry. Shaynock's artifacts were in the destroyed section of the station, as were many other relics we were analyzing. Thank you again for your efforts, but I'm afraid we're rather busy. There's much work to do to recover from this disaster.
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have any suggestions right now.
Captain, message from Starfleet. It is Admiral Redrick.
On screen. Greetings, Admiral. What can we do for you?
Jean-Luc, good to see you again. I have a little favor to ask. Would you be interested in finding a little lost lamb for me?
A lamb?
A figure of speech. I have a friend stationed on Morassia, an exobiologist. I haven't heard from her in quite a while. I'm getting a little worried. I'd like you to check into it if you can.
Cardassia? Isn't that some sort of zoological habitat?
Oh, it's much more than that, Jean-Luc. The Marassians have created three distinct biotopes, three completely different ecologies in one section of their planet. They call it the Preserve, the latest wonder of the galaxy.
Who exactly is this lost lamb?
Her name is Dr. V. Hunforsch. She was on Marassia cataloging local species for the Federation Zoological Database, but no one's seen her for days.
Have the local authorities investigated the matter?
Constable Lixie, who runs the preserve, thinks V went on a field trip and that there's nothing to worry about. To humor me, she said I should send a team to investigate.
Admiral, do you have any reason to suspect foul play?
The truth? V is headstrong, but she might be chasing butterflies. But I think there's more to it than that. And Jean-Luc, Marassia is applying for Federation membership. You could review the state of affairs there while you're looking for our exobiologist.
Very well. As soon as we receive your report, we'll get underway.
I'll transmit it immediately. Oh, and Jean-Luc, the Marassians have a strict matriarchal society. Males are usually treated as servants at best. Don't take it personally.
Understood, sir.
Good luck. Redrick out.
Lay in a course for Marassia, warp 5.
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
Warning, entering nebula. Entering non-aligned space.
Captain's log supplemental. The Enterprise has arrived at Marassia to investigate the disappearance of Dr. V. Hunforsch, an exobiologist stationed here for the past 2 years. The three species native to this world have enjoyed a millennium of peaceful cooperation, and this visit will give us the opportunity to review Marassia's petition for membership in the Federation. It's time we introduced ourselves. Mr. Worf, hail Constable Lixie.
Aye, Captain.
I'm Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise. We have come to investigate the disappearance of Dr. Hunforsch.
Welcome to Marassia. As I told Admiral Redrick, I really don't think Dr. Hundforsch is in any danger. She's probably on an extended field trip.
Good. We'll need your beam-down coordinates.
I shall transmit them. And, Captain, in order to protect the animals in the preserve, we permit no weapons of any kind on the surface.
Our away teams carry phasers for self-defense only. They can be locked on a low stun setting. I assure you none of your animals will be harmed.
I'm sorry, Captain. I won't allow it. We cannot predict how even your lowest setting will affect our animals.
We will respect your laws. The away team will not be armed.
For a male, you are unusually cooperative.
Is there any better way to begin a relationship?
Forgive me, Captain. I am not accustomed to seeing a male in command. I will await your investigators.
Coordinates selected. Coordinates selected.
Visitors for Constable Lixie.
Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hundforsch.
Welcome. So you are the artificial human. Interesting. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but there really is no need for alarm. Dr. Hundforsch is probably just on an extended field trip.
Who were the last people to see the doctor?
Apparently, Consultant Idia was the last to see her. They had dinner or some such. It's all in my report. You should be able to access it through your tricorder.
If the doctor had been injured somewhere in the preserve, would you be able to locate her?
Of course, but our surveillance system can detect signs of distress in any of our inhabitants, and we've had no sign of trouble from the doctor.
The preserve clearly embodies your philosophy of life forms living within life forms to create a single harmonious organism. It is an impressive achievement.
Very observant, Commander. Your perceptiveness does you credit.
Your tone suggests that you do not like Dr. Hundforsch.
She hasn't made many friends here. She disagrees openly with our philosophy, our methods, and has even accused us of smuggling banned species.
I would like to investigate the preserved grounds where the doctor last worked.
We'd prefer to limit the number of outsiders in the preserve while it is under construction. Investigating the doctor's laboratory should be sufficient.
A thorough investigation of the doctor's disappearance will require me to enter the preserve. Furthermore, the Federation Council has requested a review of Marassia. Unhindered access will allow me to prepare a far more detailed report.
The Federation's requests are not law here. Not yet. But in the interests of cooperation, I'll open up the area surrounding my outpost. Be sure to stay within the visitors' areas. You must understand, my responsibility to the animals comes first.
I have no more questions for you at this time. May I investigate the doctor's quarters?
Of course.
Her laboratory quarters are at the end of the path towards the mountains. What a beautiful bird.
The computer is a BAT-4003, an obsolete Milosian model. It has been modified for hand and foot operation. The computer is a... I do not believe that will work.
Cryogenically preserved specimen. This biotable has a bioassay hardware to examine specimens and read scans. Field units are built to suit different environments, so they can travel in zoological habitats and check on the animal. This Class A field unit is configured for rocky terrain and torrid climate zones. Class C field unit is configured for aquatic travel. A computer. The bioprobe removes samples from field units which collect them from animals. It's not working. It's not working. It's not working. It's not working. One message. Doctor's files have been erased. I can make out one message from her personal log. Sessions with Tracker Melas cancelled. Schedule again after field trip. Open a channel to Grower Inongo.
Channels to Grower Inongo are closed indefinitely.
Open a channel to Tracker Melas.
Channels open.
I'm Dr. Beverly Crusher of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating Dr. Hunforsha's disappearance.
Greetings. I doubt that she is in any danger. She's probably just taking a vacation after her blow-up with Constable Lixie.
I found your name in Dr. Hunforsha's lab. How do you know her?
I teach her territorial recognition. At least I did. We suspended our lessons after the power outages began. I haven't seen her since, but I doubt she's lost. Such an excellent tracker, even if she is a bit weak in the nose.
You mentioned some power outages. Could you tell me anything more about them?
A power surge at our quarantine shelter destroyed some of the generators. Two watchers were seriously injured and several animals escaped. Since then, we've had outages in the biotopes. They're still under investigation.
The constable didn't say anything about that. I suppose that with the generator out, the individual containment fields in the shelter wouldn't work either. You wouldn't be able to hold anything there.
That's right. Most of our personnel are out searching for escaped animals right now. Dr. Hunforsha might be doing that on her own.
I'd like to ask you about some animal carcasses we found in the doctor's lab.
Of course.
The doctor was only supposed to be cataloging species. What would she be doing with these carcasses?
I don't know. I haven't seen her since we suspended our lessons after the power outages.
Let's see what the bio table and a sonic scan will tell us.
I wish you well on your search.
Open a channel to Consultant Idia.
Channels to Consultant Idia are closed at this time.
It's not working.
Subject is marked as a Kujon Gibbon. Probable cause of death is massive infection by Nachirov parasites. This parasite is not native to the Kujon's habitat. Probable cause of death is neural energy loss.
Open a channel. So the constable and Dr. Hunforsha had an argument.
Dr. Hunforsha discovered that several animals from Aramut's second shipment were illegal species which had been mistagged. I think she accused the constable of smuggling, but I'm not sure. Healer Zolas told me the story.
What exactly do the watchers do?
The watchers feed and care for the preserved species.
If the accusations of smuggling were confirmed, it would seriously jeopardize Marassia's chances for membership in the Federation.
That's why she thought Constable Lixie might be involved, to thwart Federation entry.
I'd like
to... Of course.
A boar seems to have died of starvation. How could something that preventable happen here?
Hard to say. The Watchers are quite good. I can't imagine they'd just let this happen. Maybe they were given the wrong care instructions. Or maybe the animal was not identified correctly.
We found a Kujon gibbon which died from an avoidable parasitic infection. How could that happen here?
I don't know. The Watchers are the ones who care for the animals. Maybe they can help you.
We did a bioscan on a mole-like creature. There was a significant energy drain from its neural pathways.
It's probably a Myocordae mole. They're quite common on Marassia. But I've never heard of one dying like this before.
I once encountered a species that consumed human neural energy. This animal looks like it died in a similar way. Maybe one of the animals in the preserve feeds on Myocordae energy.
None that I know of. Perhaps the Myocordae got caught in one of the generator power surges, but then it wouldn't be drained of energy. I don't know.
You've been very helpful. Thank you for your time.
I wish you well on your search.
It's possible the Constable felt that telling us about her argument with the Doctor would arouse our suspicions. But why would she withhold information about the escapes?
Open a channel.
Channels to consultant.
There must be something unusual about these carcasses, or the Doctor would not have kept them. I recommend full biological and sonic scans.
Excuse me, Constable. Has there been any contact with Dr. Hinforshet?
No, I'm afraid not.
Constable, what prompted Dr. Hinforshet's smuggling accusations?
She found a Romulan creature, which is, of course, banned from import by Federation law. It was tagged as a similar legal species. She has accused me of smuggling it in order to damage our chances for Federation membership.
And how do you account for the mistagged animal?
I blame our supplier, Eremut. He's rude, devious, and barely competent. If I'd known Eremut was a Ferengi, I'd never have listened to Idia's recommendation. But the contract is binding, and he does deliver on time.
Why are you so opposed to Federation membership?
Membership in the Federation would compromise Marassia's freedom of action. Some of us would rather not see that happen. Those were just a few temperamental generators failing. They've been repaired. Is the Federation now concerned with our internal technical difficulties as well?
I consider that information relevant to my investigation. Why were you trying to hide it from me?
I'm not yet a subject of the Federation. I don't have to explain my reasons to you.
You've been very helpful.
I believe the Constable. She seems genuinely devoted to the Preserve, and I don't think she would resort to smuggling, even to thwart Federation membership.
Channel to Consultant Idia.
Channels to Consultant Idia are closed.
Subject is marked as a Maya
unit. correct. It is actually an Akana boar, a close genetic relative of the Frednorian. However, Akana are banned for import. How did this animal get into the preserve?
That's one of the new arrivals from the second shipment. Maybe there was an error. You know, we've had a number of minor problems with creatures from that shipment.
Thank you for your time.
I wish you well on your search.
Data of the Starship Enterprise? I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon Forsch.
As I told Constable...
Well on your search.
Open the channel to Consultant Idia.
Channels open.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon Forsch.
As I told Constable Lixi, I don't know where she is. Must you interrupt my research with more pointless questions?
I'm afraid so. According to the Constable's report, you are the Preserve's consultant.
Yes, I helped select and verify preserved species in the biotopes. The Marassians wanted a Federation expert, despite Lixi's objections. They were lucky to get me.
You were the last to see Dr. Hoon Forsch before her disappearance?
As far as I know, that's not a crime.
Constable Lixi mentioned that you recommended the Ferengi trader Aramut for the second shipment.
He delivers what you want on time. The Constable gave me hell when she found out that he was a Ferengi. She barely tolerates me because I'm a male.
I have some questions regarding several animal carcasses which we found in the doctor's laboratory.
Animal carcasses in an exobiology lab? Well, that's certainly unusual.
The creature tagged as a Frednorian boar apparently died of starvation. Do you know how this could have occurred?
Sounds like incompetence to me. The Watchers blindly follow whatever care instructions they're given. No personal initiative at all.
The boar's identity tag is incorrect. It is actually an Akana boar, a close genetic relative of the Frednorian. However, Akana are banned for import. How did this animal get into the preserve?
It must have been smuggled in. You know, the Watchers have requested restricted species before and were denied. Dr. Hoon Forsch must have found out about it.
Consultant, I am puzzled. Since you verify preserved species, you must have known this was an Akana. Why did you not report the misidentification?
I didn't want to. I wanted the chance to study it. It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Who am I to deprive science of my brilliant research on such a specimen?
Did the doctor confront any of the Watchers with her suspicions?
I think that's why she's missing. When she confronted them with the Akana, they must have stunned her. Those stunners don't trigger the surveillance system, so nobody knows about it.
Why would the Watchers resort to smuggling?
They're fanatics out to save the endangered creatures of the universe. I've suspected them all along, especially when I discovered this mistagging. You see, these tags can only be reprogrammed by a Watcher.
A creature tagged as a Kujan gibbon died of a parasitic infection not found in its native habitat. How could this have occurred?
I'd say it died of neglect. Those Watchers don't know the first thing about dealing with animals. They're not scientists. They're glorified zookeepers. Why don't you go ask them about it?
A mycordae mole experienced an electrical drain from its neural pathways. How could this have occurred?
I'd say it died of neglect. Those Watchers don't know the first thing about dealing with animals.
I'd like to know what you and the doctor discussed.
When I saw her for supper the other day, she was talking about genetic samples from the last shipment. She knows I don't like to hear people talk while I eat, so she said little else.
But Dr. Hoon Forsch was cataloging Marassian species exclusively. Why would she want genetic samples from other animals in the preserve?
I don't concern myself with the lab work of junior scientists. Now do you mind? I have important research to conduct.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you for wasting it.
Idia's accusation that the Watchers are fanatics is certainly plausible. Collectors can be quite zealous in their pursuit of rare specimens.
Idia certainly has a high opinion of himself. The thing he seemed most interested in was his reputation.
It's like this computer terminal's power has...
The main habitats are within the jelly...
Scans. You can view
several animals which suffered energy drains. Perhaps we could compare neuroscan.
You can find him at the quarantine shelter.
Thank you for your time.
Certainly. Good luck to you.
Idia was the last to see Dr. Humforsch before she disappeared. Idia is friends with a Ferengi, and Ferengi traders are not known for their honor. Perhaps Idia is guilty.
The Watchers suffered an electrical energy drain from their neural pathways, like the Myocorde mole. The Watchers suffered an elect...
Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Humforsch.
I'm responsible for preserve animals, not Federation scientists.
I understand the doctor spoke to you of her concerns regarding smuggling in the preserve.
Yes, she came here soon after the outages, ranting away. Imagine, accusing me, when I'm the one who told her about that boar mistagging.
What creature was in this area?
A 2-meter-long, 180-kilogram Sultis reptile, which came in on the last shipment. I found the Watchers next to its cage the night of the outages. It's still missing.
My readings show traces of a tranquilizing agent in its waste.
Aramut always doses his animals with neurotranquilizers, just like Idia. We had to feed the reptile intravenously for days. It finally woke up right before the accident, just in time to escape.
These readings share the same ionic residue as samples found near other creatures drained of electrical energy. And this cage is also next to the drain generator. Perhaps the Sultis reptile is a mistagged animal that consumes electrical energy.
But there were no reports of it being seen near any of the power outages. And that reptile isn't easy to miss. Unless it's found a way to turn itself invisible, you're going to need another theory.
We have encountered several species capable of phasing out of the time continuum and, in effect, becoming invisible. We have also encountered species who consumed human neural energy. The Sultis reptile may be a life form with similar characteristics.
Well, if you believe so, I suppose it's possible.
I have examined the neuroscans of the injured watchers. The electrical energy within their neural pathways has decreased significantly. How could that have happened?
I don't know. During my evening rounds, I found them unconscious next to the Sultis reptile cage. I carried them outside the shelter and was going for help when the generators exploded.
Were you the one who found the carcass?
Yes. It died just before the outages, and I wanted her to test it.
Why did you not ask Consultant Idiot to test the carcass?
I don't trust him. Always drugging and borrowing animals for his experiments. In the interests of science, he says. I don't know how he could have approved that mistagging in the first place.
Do the Watcher stunners set off the preserve surveillance system?
The system only detects signs of distress. Normal sleep does not raise an alarm. Likewise, stunners and neurotranquilizers also don't alert the system. Unlike Idia and Aramet, we prefer stunners. Chemical sedation can be harmful.
Consultant Idia mentioned that only watchers can change the ID tags.
That's true, but the suppliers tag the animals first. We just match them up with the constable's shipping orders. Idia is responsible for verifying them.
Is it true that the Watcher's requests for restricted species were rejected?
Only 4 species out of 112. Of course, we were upset at first, but once the preserve is completed, we can always try again.
When did you last see Dr. Hune Forsch?
I haven't seen her for some time. I've been busy recovering animals which escaped during the power outages. It's not easy work. The last time I saw her, I sent her to talk to Aramet.
Thank you for your time.
What's your step now?
Idia persuaded the constable to use Aramet, and Idia is also capable of verifying mistagged species. And he had the neurotranquilizers to knock out Dr. Hune Forsch if she posed a threat to him.
Only stunners or drugs could disable someone without setting off the surveillance systems. Idia has a supply of neurotranquilizers.
Constable, we have reason to believe that Consultant Idia smuggled rare species into the preserve through his friend Aramet.
Are you trying to pick up where Dr. Hune Forsch left off? She accused nearly everyone else of the same thing.
Consultant Idia persuaded you to hire Aramet, and he knowingly verified mistagged animals. He also uses neurotranquilizers, which could have stunned Dr. Hune Forsch without triggering your surveillance systems.
Idia's been nothing but trouble since he got here. This time he's gone too far. I'll send for him so we can settle this once and for all.
please wait here until Constable Lixie returns.